There is only so much land in Europe, but we ask a lot of it. We want to meet growing food demands, but at the same time we want to preserve, ideally even restore some nature. There are two main schools of thought about the best strategies to accommodate both needs. The first is land sharing, promoting more wildlife-friendly forms of farming. But because the yields are lower, it needs more space. And this is why land sparing, the other strategy, advocates for more intense forms of farming to then save space for nature elsewhere. None of these strategies, however, is really a one-fits-all solution. And whereas in some areas the benefits of wildlife-friendly farming might outweigh the opportunity cost, in other areas it just won't. And then again, in other areas, there might be very high potential to actually restore pristine ecosystems. And here it might be the best just abandon any kind of farming. So moving away from this black and white thinking, the question rather becomes, how much do we want of each and where do we want it? And this is the question I focus on with my research. I do this by modeling the pros and cons of different landscape developmental trajectories, namely intensification, extensification, and abandonment. First, I map the potential impacts of each trajectory on 10 different ecosystem service and biodiversity indicators. Using these impacts, I then identified for each trajectory regions where the total amount of benefits or costs would be high or low. Combining these then into a single map per trajectory, you can see where the benefits are high in comparison to the costs, or the opposite way around. So what I want you to remember from this is that the reconciliation of nature and agriculture in Europe is not an easy task. I would like you to think about what it means to have sustainable landscape development. Maybe moving away from ideas like all intensive agriculture is bad. Because intensification, extensification and abandonment each have a place in sustainable landscape development. However, because the impacts are so spatially variable, we need to start targeting areas for each trajectory.